Good morning. My name is Yantje Wongso. I'm here representing my company from Indonesia named PT Biru Semesta Abadi. The company franchises stores that sells only one product, drinking water. It opened up its first store in 2002, and at present, the company has been operating more than 333 stores in Indonesia. I will present to you an important ideas based on a value observation on tap water quality for drinking. It is a huge subject matter indeed, but as I have very short moments, I will try to pinpoint the ideas as simple as possible. Those who travel may experience different tap water qualities in countries they have traveled to. Most developed countries say that their tap water is potable, while most developing countries say that their tap water is not potable. So, which of these has a better tap water quality, developed or developing countries? The answer seems very obvious, but let us discuss the subject of the value of quality in further detail. The term value is defined as quality divided by cost. The higher the quality, the higher the value. While the higher the cost, the lower the value. So, if value being observed on tap water quality for drinking, which tap water quality has a better value? Quality is directly related to usability. In terms of water quality, does the quality for drinking, bathing, toilets, dishwashing, and watering plants all have the same quality standard requirements? If drinking water is used for watering plants, isn't it too excessive in quality? We surely won't have any difficulty answering these questions because they are very obvious. Practically, the highest water quality, which is healthy water, is for drinking. Safe water quality is for dishwashing, laundry, and bathing. And clean water quality is to flush the toilets, water the plants, and wash the car. If further simplified, two qualities of water can be distinguished, namely healthy water and clean water. What happens then if healthy water is used for a purpose other than drinking? The obvious answer is the occurrence of a waste of resources, namely the use of investment funds, technology, human capital, raw materials, and so more. The waste resources is related to the water treatment process to achieve quality according to its use, and also to water distribution management to users. How much of a waste is that? To answer this question, let's picture this. What if we use commercial bottled drinking water to flush our toilet, to water our garden, do our dishes, do our laundry? Using drinking water, which is the highest quality water, to do all this would be such a huge, huge waste indeed. Imagine if we must pay the price of bottled drinking water for these usages. Surely we will be very reluctant. Cited from the book titled The State of the World's Water, an atlas of our most vital resource, written by Magic Black, published in 2016 by New Internationalist Oxford, UK, home water consumption for drinking counts only for 4%. That means in many countries with drinkable tap water, 96% of water usage have very low value because of the high cost relative to quality of water needed for these usages. A real massive waste of valuable resources. In conclusion, I encourage governments from both developed and developing countries to better allocate their limited resources by focusing on providing clean tap water for residential areas in the city. It would be most efficient if government provide clean water through centralized production facilities in a large economic of scale. As for drinking water, the government can provide decentralized solution by forming smaller production units at population points to improve the water quality from clean tap water to healthy water for consumption. These drinking water production units must be managed both commercially and socially, namely as an independent non-profit commercial depot. This non-profit commercial depot will open up jobs as depot operators and will have commercial power to finance themselves independently, which include the procurement of investment funds to develop depot facilities and to maintain facilities on an ongoing basis. Consumers of this non-profit drinking water depot will also create cost efficiency from appropriate use of drinking water. In other words, create the highest value for drinking water. On behalf of BIRU franchise and its 2,400 direct workers, I thank you all for your attention. Our deep gratitude and appreciation to a European Society for Quality Research for granting our company, PT BIRU Semesta Abadi, the Best Quality Leadership Award 2018. May God bless you all.